Alright, the iPhone SE 2020 has been launched. There is some exciting thing here which may make it worth the price, and some boring that may not be worth the asking price. Like right off the bat, it's available for like $399 US, and that may not translate well with the pricing in India here. So, well, firstly, the phone could cater the needs of people who are looking for a powerful compact phone that doesn't weigh much and is easy on the hands with long-term reliability, because the screen size is only 4.7 inches there. Secondly, if you are someone looking for a second phone or a business purpose only phone, this could be the perfect phone out there. Okay, so what's exciting thing here is it comes with A13 Bionic Chip, which is found in its bigger brother or flagship iPhone 11 phone. So what does it mean? It means faster performance and eases multitasking for a 4.7 inch screen phone. So quickly looking at the specification, the screen size, like I said, is 4.7 inches, similar to the older iPhone 8 or earlier models, that to non-plus models. Weighs light at only 148 grams and is IP67 water resistant up to 1 meter for like 30 minutes, which is cool, I think. But the bad thing here is the screen to body ratio, guys, which is approximately like only 65%. Wow, that's like a lot of bezels for a phone in 2020, and has same display brightness as the iPhone 11 at 625 nits, which is awesome. Again, looking at the size and the bezels, which may not translate to that awesomeness while you are actually using the phone itself. And here the base variant is 64 GB. There is also 128 GB and 256 GB variants, and all the variants will have 3 GB RAM only. Again, a slight con I felt, because the iPhone 11 has 4 GB RAM with all the variants, I guess. Now here only 3 GB, but considering the screen size is only 4.7 inches and that doesn't require a lot of processing power there, so I think it's fine for the processing power and such a small screen size. Another exciting and not so exciting as well is with the camera department here. It comes with 12 megapixel f1.9 aperture camera, which looks similar to the iPhone 11 and could have been awesome, but according to a report, the camera module on both phones is just not the same. Which leads us to actually test the camera itself, the camera quality, because it's just not the same. The selfie camera here is mere 7 megapixel at f2.2 aperture, which is really disappointing. But then again, if you're using it as a secondary phone, it shouldn't matter much over there. Occasional selfies should do fine. 4K video recording at up to 60 frames per second is there, fortunately. It also supports fast charging at 18 watts only. The battery capacity here is just 1821 mAh, which is pretty small. Again, only time will tell how's the battery backup actually while you're using the phone itself. Okay guys, so only two exciting things here I found. Like, one is the A13 Bionic Chip, which gets the job done way faster, and a 12 megapixel camera at f1.9 aperture, which can be a good camera and also records 4K at up to 60 frames per second. Now looking at the pricing here, the base variant, like I said, costs $399 US, which is just fine. And if you're someone looking for a secondary phone or a no-nonsense compact phone, you could just go ahead and buy this one. But in India, it could cost like over 42,500. The website says MRP is 42,500, which makes me not recommend it and look for any other alternatives out there. But if you're looking for an iPhone only, then this could be your phone. So what do you guys think of this iPhone SE 2020? Let me know in the comment section down below. Will you actually buy this one? Also, let me know in the comment section down below. And yeah, guys, this was launched iPhone SE 2020, and just wanted to share you the news. And yeah, guys, hit that like button, and don't forget to click on that subscribe button if you are new to my channel. I will see you all in another one. Till then, take care, everyone. Bye-bye.